My father, they're both 62 years old. My father was 50. He looked like a light-skinned black dude. He just a regular, fair-skinned, a little lighter than me, fair-skinned black dude. Over like the last 10, 12 years, my father has become a 5'7 Filipino man. I know it sounds awkward, but because it is. All my friends meet my dad and be like, yo, this Asian dude. This your dad right here? I'm like, yeah, you know, he didn't start off that way, but like. But that's who he became after loving for who he is, okay? And it's weird, because I'm like, hey, you know, fellas, this is my dad. They all, Mr. Bells. I'm like, he's not Asian. You know? You don't have to bow. What are you doing? And he dresses like an old Asian dude, too. You ever seen an old Asian dude like at like North Park Mall or some shit? You ever seen an old Asian dude walking around? They just wear flowy clothes. They don't care about fashion. They just wear comfortable clothes. They just walk around the mall like this. They just walk around looking at architecture. All I want to do is like, I just want to help him out because he just dresses weird right now. He just wants to wear comfortable clothes. All his clothes are so big. I'm like, I'm doing all right, man. Let me buy you some clothes. Man, I don't need no clothes. Yes, you do. My dad has one pair of jeans. One! One pair of jeans, he calls them the jeans. Oh, we going to the mall? Let me run upstairs and put on the jeans real quick. Stop, why are you walking backwards? Come here, don't do that, come here. I'm gonna go throw on the jeans. You going upstairs like that? You can go upstairs backwards, but I'm gonna put on the jeans real quick. Stop doing that. And they're so wide, they're wide as fuck. They're so wide. They're so wide. They don't touch his legs or his shoes. They don't touch his legs or my father could do like this. They wouldn't touch shit. They would just hover around his calf muscles. He could drop a tennis ball from his waist to the floor. He wouldn't touch nothing. It would just, they're so wide. I'm always like, Dad, man, let me get you some new pants, man. I don't need no pants. I'm like, well, what do you want? Give me some DVDs. What? Why do you want DVDs? I collect DVDs. Why? They're not collector's items. I know the box says that, but that's marketing. They don't mean that shit. My father, in my house, Decatur, Georgia, my father has an 8x10-foot shelf. Just straight DVD. It's crazy. He thinks when people stop by, they're impressed by this shit. Hey, how you doing? You look good. How's your wife? You see my DVDs? And they're organized by actor. That's not a joke. They're organized by actor, and if two big actors share a movie, he buys two copies so they can share it together. It's ridiculous. And I got him all the, you know, all the streaming services, he has all the movies he can get just online. I'm like, Dad, I got you Netflix, Amazon, Hulu, HBO shows. I got you all that shit. Why are you still buying DVDs? He goes, first of all, thank you. Second of all, what if the power goes out? Hmm? Yeah, you right. Because I know he meant Wi-Fi. I know he meant Wi-Fi. God damn, I hope he meant Wi-Fi. I just gotta find a way to get him out of these pants, man. It's goddamn. Cause like these jeans that look at, oh my God. If you saw them, you'd be like, they don't sell these in stores. This is not, you can't just buy these at a place, okay? You gotta know somebody in the alley. And a special night, you gotta go. Fuck you on. Hey man, I came to buy some pants to embarrass my family. Do you have what I'm looking for? Man, hey, get your ass here. We got exactly what you're looking for. We got jeans on the left, DVDs on the right. So do whatever you want.